Alabama had tasted victory 11 times in 1992, 8 times against Southeastern Conference competition. But in order to become champions of the SEC, the Crimson Tide would have to conquer Steve Spurrier's Florida Gators.
The 92 game obviously was the first SEC championship game. I don't know if people exactly knew what to expect, how it would be. It turned out to be a great sort of inaugural game for the series.
It's the first ever. It's the inaugural SEC championship game, and it's kind of like, okay, here we are, 11-0, and we could normally just be walking into the national championship game. Miami gets to sit at home, not to worry about this, and now we've got to play in this first, you know, SEC title game. From our standpoint, it's kind of like, okay, well, it's a great challenge because we get to face off against a really good football team, but on the other side of that, it's like, why this year? Why can't this been 93 or 94? Why do we have to be the first year after we've done so well?
We didn't like the idea. We didn't. Especially, I mean, the beginning of the season wasn't that bad because you didn't really think much about it. But once you're in a position to win a national championship, and now you have to play this extra game against a great opponent, then you get to thinking about, okay, why we got to play this game?
A victory would also extend the overall winning streak to 22 games, a streak that dates back to last September when Bama suffered its most recent defeat, a humiliating defeat to the very same Gators that stood across the field in Birmingham.
Build up to that leading into it was just huge. I mean, you talk about media coverage. That game, I think, helped prepare us for the national championship game because the pressure was so heightened.
Going into that game, we knew that if we win this game, that we was going to have a chance to play for the national championship. It was the pressure to win the ball game, but then it was that motivation that you have to win this to go to the next level.
It was at Legion Field, one of the two games that was played outdoors in Birmingham before they moved to the Georgia Dome for the 1994 game. Very cold weather, great crowd, obviously. Florida played extremely well, and it was such a competitive game, ended up probably in some ways being the national championship game for Alabama. Florida ended up being a much more difficult opponent than Miami did in the Sugar Bowl.
Florida was the best team we was going to play the whole year, and we knew that. I mean, they had a great offense, great quarterback, great running game, whatever, right? Had a great defense. And we know by far that this will be our toughest challenge.
This big matchup between two SEC powers. Florida's kind of the Johnny-come-lately team, you know, with Steve Spurrier. And here we are coming in this game, and we've got to win it to get to the national title game to play in Miami. Key plays for us on offense, the way we ran the football that day. I remember hitting Curtis Brown a post route, something we'd worked on all week about, you know, looking the safety down to get over the top of him. Was able to hit him for a touchdown pass. Hitting David on a streak route down the sidelines where had to make a throw that would had allowed him to have to dive for the ball, but that's the only place I could put it. And he just made a spectacular catch, which gave us a first down. But Antonio's pick was huge.
It was driving the football. On this game was tied. They're driving the football. We got to have a big play. I mean, they're driving the football. They have momentum. They have everything. That's when Antonio Langham make that big interception and run it back for a touchdown.
It's 21-21, and Florida has the ball in the late going, and Antonio Langham makes a tremendous interception, returns it to the end zone, and Alabama, very appropriately for the 1992 team, wins on defense.
And Antonio comes up with a big pick. He did it against Auburn in 92. He did it against Florida, you know, to take that ball back for a touchdown. And, I mean, we just knew at that time, you know, this is a team of destiny. We win it, the first one, and all of a sudden we're headed to play for the national championship.
That was a defining moment for that football team because when we had to have that play, we got it done. And the rest of it is history.
But I think it was just such an exciting game, such a classic of its kind, that it was just a great way for SEC championship games to get started and is really probably in terms of excitement, competitiveness, and so forth, the best game of the 1992 season.